crime show.
You summoned me?
Wait, if I summoned you, why am I at your place?
I finally decided that paying that premium for anti-portal insurance was worth it.
Sure, yeah, I'll pretend that makes sense. Anyway, you want to do a crossover?
Sure, what are we doing?
The Magic School Bus Rides Again Crime Investigation Episode Claw and Order.
Oh.
Yeah. Hello and welcome to Crowforest Reviews.
And welcome to Crime Show Crossovers.
The Magic School Bus Rides Again, Claw and Order.
Yeah, that.
Yay. So the episode opens with Wanda feeding her new pet bird on the lawn outside the school.
But then tragedy strikes, as it turns out that the classroom has been ransacked, and the pepperoni has been stolen off the pizza.
And also, a little figurine from the fish tank was stolen.
Yeah, but mostly the pepperoni.
Well, I'm contractually obligated to mention the aquarium toys that were involved in this heist. So anyway, Miss Frizzle, or rather, not Miss Frizzle, which is to say the new Miss Frizzle, who's still Miss Frizzle because she's the younger sister of the original Miss Frizzle and thus has the same name, even though it really doesn't make sense for her to be the younger sister of the original Miss Frizzle.
So anyway, Miss Frizzle is way too excited by the prospect of a criminal investigation in her classroom, to the point where she actually puts on a stereotypical detective's costume, complete with hat and magnifying glass.
And so, with the criminal investigation underway, Liz draws chalk lines around the pizza box, and Carlos says something about going up a tube slide backwards with a toothbrush? What?
This case is gonna be tough. Tougher than going backwards up a tube slide. Tougher than carving a jack-o'-lantern with a toothpick. Tougher than...
Would you stop talking and help?
So the class all set about doing various crime scene investigator things. Judy takes pictures, Keisha takes notes, Ralphie places numbered table tens, and Arnold dusts for fingerprints.
And Carlos makes fish puns.
Strange.
There's something fishy about this case. Get it, fishy?
Yes, thank you. That was very relevant.
A feather. Starting to wonder if we're not solving a whodunit, but a whatdunit.
Really? You're not gonna go with the... Maybe it's not a whodunit, but a who done it, because maybe it was an owl.
So anyway, Wanda comes in with her bird, and everyone immediately suspects that the poor bird must be behind the nefarious ransacking and theft.
And so, with their number one suspect in custody, Carlos starts to interrogate the unfortunate magpie, backwards chair and all.
And Keisha demands to know exactly where the bird was at 10:57 a.m. I guess they're doing the whole good cop, bad cop thing.
But who's the good cop and who's the bad cop?
I don't know.
Everybody gets hungry. I do.
Stop being so nice. Where were you at 10:57 this morning, bird?
But Wanda puts a stop to the interrogation, since her bird doesn't have legal counsel. And so Carlos and Keisha decide to check his nest for evidence instead.
But before they can legally check his nest for evidence, they're going to have to obtain a search warrant, which means they have to go and visit the DA.
Let's check his nest for evidence. You can't just do that. You'll need a search warrant. Fine, we'll talk to the DA. She'll give it to us. The DA? You mean...
Dorothy Ann!
Damn it! That joke was too obvious!
So with the newly obtained search warrant, the class all files onto the bus and go to investigate the nest.
Wow! Does a nest ever look different up close?
Yes? I'm guessing that yes, it would look different up close, but you're the ones looking at it up close, so shouldn't you know the answer to that question? Is that a trick question?
You'd think. But then, before they have time to actually gather any evidence, they all get back onto the bus, which then proceeds to turn into a bird. These people have any idea what an actual investigation is?
So the class are taking a little side trip to learn about different birds and how they're individually adapted for their particular needs.
And what they find all points to Wanda's bird being guilty, since the footprints they find at the crime scene match the bird's, with three claws facing forward and one claw facing back.
And moreover, they find the missing aquarium figurine in the magpie's nest.
Case closed. Or at least it would be if Wanda didn't help her bird resist arrest.
Here comes our suspect now. No, Ruddy, go, run, fly, get out of here! I don't believe it!
You actually helped Marty resist arrest?
Damn it, that's gonna be a lot of extra paperwork.
And so the bird bus follows the bird, and they somehow manage to capture it, despite being the same size as it. Wow, you can accomplish anything with a jump cut.
No, Marty! Go away! You're in charge of Marty until the trial.
So Wanda is tasked with preventing her bird from leaving the country and showing up for his court date on time. Which, wouldn't you think that'd be an issue given that she already helped the bird resist arrest? Shouldn't he be given, you know, a different parole officer?
Yeah, kind of a conflict of interests, really.
Yeah.
But Wanda still doesn't believe that her bird is the culprit, and she's determined to clear his name. So Wanda gets Jyoti's help to analyze the footprints that were found at the scene.
So realizing that the original investigation was compromised by the confirmation bias, i.e. they first decided that Wanda's bird was guilty, and then found evidence to support the preconceived idea, they decide to go back over the evidence from a different angle. Now, instead of trying to find evidence against Wanda's bird, they start looking for other birds that fit the same profile.
But before they can get the evidence they need, they're snatched out of the sky by an eagle. For the third time that week.
Moving on. Or not. Oh, what do you know? We've been snatched by an eagle. Third time this week for me.
But the bird lets them go, and they go off to explore more evidence, examining bird feet from Florida, Canada.
Next up, Canada! Ooh, a crane!
Wait, what? Why are they going to Canada? What would a Canadian bird have been doing at their school? What possible use can this have to their case?
Maybe it was a Canadian exchange bird?
That's not a thing!
It's Magic School Bus! Everything is a thing! Yeah, Wanda is so determined to clear her bird's name that she's willing to go to other countries to find a possible scapegoat. They just switched out one kind of confirmation bias for another.
And so, having proven that the vandalizer of the school was definitely not a penguin or an ostrich...
Really? A penguin or an ostrich? We had to go there.
It's time for the trial.
Dun dun dun!
He's innocent until proven guilty. It's time for a trial!
And the crazy thing is, this isn't even the first Magic School Bus episode to feature a trial. In a Pickle from the original did too.
Why are we featuring that one instead?
I don't know.
At least that had the subplot of pickle trafficking.
What? So we get to the trial, and Dorothy Ann is leading the prosecution. Because, you know, she's the district attorney. Because of having the same initials. And that's it.
This bird clearly flew in the open window, used his beak to crack seeds, peck fruit, and pilfer the beloved aquarium figurine. Nothing was sacred. Not even... the pepperoni!
The case isn't going well for Wanda's bird, leading her to say that the only way for him to get out of the situation is for something unexpected to happen, completely out of the blue.
If only something unexpected would happen, completely out of the blue! Everyone, come quick! Something unexpected happened, completely out of the blue!
What? Something unexpected happened, completely out of the blue?
Oh no!
Oh yeah!
It turns out that while the trial was going on, the classroom was broken into again and more food was stolen, leaving Wanda's bird completely off the hook.
Moreover, this time around, they discover two distinct sets of footprints, indicating that it was carried out by one bird with two kinds of feet.
There are four toad prints again! But also these! What kind of bizarro Frankenbird has two kinds of feet?
Definitely. Or maybe two different kinds of birds did it.
We've managed to pull two full right handprints from the wall, but they don't match. We can't figure it out. I mean, what kind of bizarro Frankenperp has two right hands?
Maybe it was two different perps, dumbass!
Anybody know how we can catch the culprit in the act?
Time machine! Duh!
Okay. Thank you, Ralphie, yes.
Why are you so quick to dismiss the time machine idea? The bus has been a time machine on more than one occasion.
Yeah, but this is the crime scene episode, so the correct answer she's looking for was stakeout!
Oh, okay.
You know, for kids!
But there's actually another little trick of the trade used by everyone from bird watchers to spies.
Stakeout!
So they set a trap to catch the birds in the act and discover that it was none other than the notorious crime duo of a duck and a red bird. That's a little anticlimactic.
And so they finally do what they should have done right from the start, as order more pizza and close the window. They could have avoided this whole situation.
So that was Claw in Order. Butter. Ow.
That episode was, strange. Very strange. It did have a pretty clever way of showcasing the different traits of birds.
Even when their framing device made no sense. I mean, penguins? Really?
Yeah, that was weird. But still, on the whole, it does work pretty well, and it does have some good lines here and there.
And some really bad ones.
Yes, and some bad ones. But if you're looking for a crime show episode that teaches about the different types of birds, then, well, I don't think you're going to find another one.
Well, that's all for now. Until next time, here's your kid-friendly clip of the day.
No! Lock him up! Throw away the key!
But before they can legally check his nest for evidence, they have to obtain a search warrant. So they're going to have to go and see the DA. No.
Mm.
No!
Yeah. Yeah.